open Telegram web app or Android app. Type here bot further, and it will ask us to start new bot here. It's a command which allows us to create a new bot. Shall it gives error? See, this will come like this. I can help you create and manage Telegram bot. If you are new to the bot API, please see the manual. You can control me by sending this commands: slash new bot slash my bot, edit bot settings here. So I want to create new bot here. So backslash new bot. So we'll give like, all right, a new bot. How we are going to call it? Please choose a name for bot. So codename home. I'm selecting codename home. Good. Now let's choose a username for your bot. It must end with bot here. So I'm taking as light. Codename light underscore bot. This is the name which I am giving you to this one bot, codename light underscore bot. This is a bot which I am going to give for my bot ID. This is, so once we created bot here and it gives us token ID to access API key here. So in our agenda, we have completed first task, creating bot in Telegram here. Next, we need to configure this Telegram bot with our NodeMCU. So open Arduino IDE. First thing we need to have is ctbot. So check whether it is available or not here. Go to include libraries, click on manage library, when you open the library manager, it will always takes updates here. Updating list of libraries installed. So once it get updated, it will ask us to enter name which you want to search here. So ctbot is chatbot. See, if you did not install here, you can click on here and install. I already installed it, so no problem for me. Close this one and write here code. First thing is we need to import library here, hash include ctbot.h. It's a library which we need to include here, and we need to create a variable for this ctbot, my bot. Close with semicolon, and next declare the SSID and password. SSID should be in string format. SSID equals to codename COE and pass equals to, which is password equals to going to create a token here. String s should be capital here. In string s should be capital. If you forgot to write s, it will throw an error for us. So string token equals to, so what is the token which we get from this one? So go to here in bot further, it will allocate a token for us. So that just copy this one and open our Arduino IDE and place it here. And then we need to declare our pins here. Format underscore T and int 8 is the format where we can declare variables here. So red LED equals to D1 and 8 underscore T equals to green LED equals to D0, or we can go for D2. There are two LEDs which we are going to control now. So next thing, in setup we need to initialize our serial monitor. So serial dot begin of 115200, it's a baud rate, and then write a serial print here, serial dot println println of starting. Telegram board. We'll print this one in serial monitor. Next, we need to connect to our Wi-Fi credentials. So my board dot connect. Connect in the sense Wi-Fi connect here. So Wi-Fi and G should be capital. It is, everything is case sensitive here. So Wi-Fi connect here. So give the SSID comma pass, which is password, and then we need to assign our token, which token we need to connect, which is our Telegram bot is connected with token here. So my bot dot set Telegram token of token here. So we are assigning token values here. If when we give a token API to this one, so we need to check whether it is connected with our bot or not. So if my bot dot test connection then print serial dot print ln of backslash n connection test is okay. Else serial dot print ln of backslash n connection test is not okay. And now we'll declare our pin modes here. So pin mode of is what the pin we have given, D1 and D2. So red LED comma out, OUT out, output output output. Next pin mode of green LED comma output. Initially we should off the our LEDs. So I'm connecting LED in pull up mode. So we need to we can connect LEDs in pull up and pull down mode. So which means when we give high, it should on. Then it is called as pull up mode. When we give low, it should on. It is called pull down mode. So I am going to give LED in pull down mode. Or we can give it as pull up or pull down mode. So it is an effect for us. So in the sense, the difference, main difference is the power supply which we choose. We want to give power supply with the help of our pin, is D1 pin or VIN pin. If we want to give power supply with VIN, we should connect anode to VIN and cathode to D1. If you want to connect our LED in pull down mode, we need to give anode to D1 pin and cathode to ground pin. So this is the process which we follow there. So next we will jump into loop section. We'll create a variable called TB message MSG, and then because we need to read the messages from the Telegram board which we are getting there. So if my bot dot get new, if my bot dot get new message MSG, then what I should do there. So if message dot text dot equal, in the sense what we read, sometimes we will give uppercase or sometimes we will give lowercase letters. So doesn't make any, we should say to the board, don't confuse it. Whatever the letter given format, whether it is in uppercase or in lowercase, we should give the proper output here. So in the sense, we are writing this equal ignore case of red, write on. And if we get any message called red light on, then we should on our red light here. So digital right off red light, in the sense red LED comma, what the case we are giving here, whether if you want to give a pull up or pull down. So I'm using it as pull down mode. So I will give high here, capital high. And I want to reply to the user there. So MSG my bot dot send message of MSG dot sender dot id comma, should reply to this user like your red LED is on, your red LED is on. This is the thing we need to give for if we get a command called red LED on. So we need to on the LED and we need to reply back to the user by saying that your LED is on, your red LED is on. If we get red LED is off, we should off the LED here. Now else if else if my bot, sorry, message dot text dot equal ignore case of red light off. Or in the sense we need to close here the loop, proper loop closing, and then here also should close the if loop, and here we need to start writing the thing here. So else if message dot text dot equal ignorance case of red LED off, then we need to off our LED here. Digital write off red LED comma low and send message to the bots by saying that msg dot sender dot id comma your red LED is off, and then we start another loop for green LED here. If my bot dot get, or we can go with msg dot text dot equal ignorance ig case green LED on, then we should on the green LED here. Digital write off green LED comma high, and we should reply back to the user by saying that my bot dot send message to msg dot sender dot id comma your green LED is on. Close the if loop, and else if for off msg dot text dot equal ignore case of green LED off. Close the loop and write we should off the green LED here. Green LED comma low, and we need to reply to the bot by saying that your green LED is off. Message of msg dot sender dot id comma Your green lady is off. This is how we write here, and then else. Once we return for one loop, which is for if got any message here, so else here is else. Always we need to follow the loops parentheses here. So we have open here, so we need to close it here, close the end of this if loop. So we close it here, okay, and this one is here, okay, and this one is here, and this one is here. Now this one for if my bot dot get message, if we didn't get any message, so else string replay. See, sometimes we'll give the thing there, so light on, right, light off, light on, like this. So we need to give the proper suggestions there. For that we need to give a strong replay to them, so which means to replay properly, to send the command properly. So string of, in string we should always write S as capital, string of welcome message dot sender dot username plus string in S. In string S should be capital, colon dot try light on or light off. So it should be in capital letters or in small letters, it's up to us. So you should write with light on and close this one with semicolons. And msg my bot dot send message, here m should be capital, of msg dot sender dot id plus comma replay. We should close this loop and then delay of 50 milliseconds. So we need to check proper the where we have closed everything here. So yeah, remove this one and press it here, okay, and check whether how many parentheses we have kept here for this loop. This one ended, okay. For this one, okay, and now for this one, for this, okay. This is how we can debug the code before entering into the point. So first, just verify the code by clicking right mark here and save the code here. We'll take time for compiling the sketch. Here we miss the semicolon. Here also we miss the semicolon. We check whether we have miss here. From here also we have checked the semicolon here. Okay, till where we have left here. So everything is fine. Just check for the syntaxes here. If any syntax is misses, automatically it will show an error for us. Pass what we have declared here, P should be capital, so we have given small. So was the one mistake. If we give anything capital, we should always follow the capital. If we give any small letter, we should follow every time we use that word in the small letter only. S should be capital here. Once we check this with one, then we can go with the connections part. B should be capital. So we are going to connect LEDs here, big terminal, okay. Now I'm going to connect D1 red LED in pull down mode. So big terminal is connected to D1 and small terminal is connected to ground, and for green LED I'm connecting big terminal with D2 and small terminal with ground. Our code is dumped successfully. So open our board and start here. Write the letter called red LED on. Welcome null. Try red LED on or off. It is showing the replay for us, but our LED is not on here. So go for red LED off. It's not taking things here properly. So let me check in this code. What do I have written here? Red LED on, red LED D1. So change the connections here. Go with the V1, just change the connections with 3.3V and VCC V in, and look for the connections part here. So now check with red LED on. Red LED off. Okay, check with green LED. Green LED on. It's working right. So give to ground here. Yeah. Now your green LED is on. Green LED off. So green LED is off. So problem is with red LED here. So let me clear it here. So digital write what the pin we have given, red LED. And okay, right, red LED on. It's working with green LED, why not red LED here? So red light on. So we need to go with red light on here. Command is red light on. See, now red light is on. And then we need to off our red LED here. So red light off. Your red LED is off. This is how we can go with the flow here. So when you write whatever the things right here, should be same thing you should write there. So if you write red LED on, we should also same thing we need to go here itself. So you can check here, see first commands which I have written here. If I write red LED on, but there is no LED here, so we should write red light on here, then only it will come. And here I have written red green LED, so it came here. When I go with red LED off also, it doesn't came because I have written light here. So when I remove this one, if I write red LED and LED and upload the code, once I get uploaded to the code, then I can change the commands there according to the things which we have written in the code. We should follow the commands there itself in Telegram board. So it's done uploading, I think so. Done uploading. There you can go with now red LED on. Or red LED is on. So if you go with red LED off, red LED will be off. And if you want to on green LED, green LED on, green LED is on. If you want to off your green LED can be off by using this command. This is how we can control things by using Telegram bot, and we can replace those LEDs with the relays, and we can do home automation projects also with the help of this code here.
I hope you have enjoyed watching it. If you have liked our content, please do hit like button and do subscribe to our YouTube channel for more useful content and exciting updates. If you want to learn such practical content at an affordable cost with Microsoft certification and instructor support, please register at academy.codenan.com. You can also download app from Play Store as Codenan. Never hesitate to raise queries in the comment section, and please do reply with your suggestions for more practical videos. We'll be happy to come up with it. Thank you.